Hey everybody, it's time to take a look at another Batman cowl. This one's a little bit less awkward looking than the first one that we got. This is the classic 1966 TV series based one, so the original live action Batman version as, you know, a cowl as a regular desk model in the same series that they've been doing for some time now. Roughly the same scale as the first cowl that they did, and the exact same price. This is $60 US, 60 euros, or 55 pounds in the UK. This is coming out in October, I think October 1 is when this comes out. This one will have only 372 pieces, compared to 410 pieces for the modern styled one. So this one is just very, very straightforward compared to the modern styled one that they did with its appearance as just a cowl. They didn't try to put something in front of it. They didn't try to make the mannequin, the glass mannequin sort of look in here. So this is just a lot more straightforward, and I think it's easier for this to make sense to us, you know, as viewers. This uses stickers. You can see stickers are used up here. Those are probably prototype stickers that were used at that time. They don't look all that great, but I think I can zoom in. Yeah, I can zoom in. But this does appear to be a printed piece that is printed all the way across for the nose. The color, I believe, is a dark blue, and I think that this one is just spray painted, because again, I think this was just a prototype, but yeah, that's all good. The accuracy looks pretty good to me. Colors are certainly right. You know, this is making things right, just like the most recent minifig version of a classic Batman does that came with the 1966 classic TV Batmobile. So overall, I think that this thing is looking pretty good. I don't know why this image is smaller than the others. I think I grabbed the best images that I could, but yeah, overall, I'm pretty happy with the shaping. Maybe a little bit straight here, but that's completely forgivable. It's a little bit difficult to stomach the price, in my personal opinion, given that this has even fewer pieces. It's more obviously hollow. And looks like it would have far fewer pieces than the modern version that they came out with first, but it actually is within the same range. So the price to part ratio kind of thing is similar if you care about that. But what's more important is with these lifestyle photos, we also get the ones with the models, the human models in there. And I feel like this model is actually taking this very, very seriously and is actually doing the assembly here. You know, oftentimes these things look super, super posed, but I feel like she is really into this and really feels like she is doing kind of a service to this Batman cowl, like putting Humpty Dumpty back together or something. Like there's some genuine satisfaction there, and it looks like she's doing something good for the world, and she's happy about that. She's not going to go post about it all over social media or anything. It just feels good to her. So I'm happy for that. This gets a little bit awkward though, because the way she's looking at it right now is like, did that Batman cowl just thank me for putting it back together? You know, again, with the Humpty Dumpty kind of thing I'm going with here. I could have sworn I heard it. It's like maybe I just felt it in my head. There's great joy and gratitude, Star Trek Next Generation reference, coming from this Batman cowl there. Did you hear that? Like, if there's somebody else in the room, the photographers or whatever, did you hear that? I think she's taking this a little bit too seriously. So this went from kind of adorable to a little bit, nice to know you, shake hands, good photo shoot. Okay, yeah, don't call us, we'll call you. Yikes. But the cowl, I think it's fine. Just that's a render there. Hey, oh, hi. that's a render. But yeah, I think it looks decent. But $60 for that doesn't feel great to me. $60 for that probably feels worse to me than any of the other things in this series across the board. Even the Iron Man one. Sorry, crossing the DC and the Marvel because I can. Even that one that didn't look that great still looked like a better value than this, in my opinion. But at least this is less awkward with just a straight plinth in it to hold it up than the first one. So I'm all kind of all over the place on this. Some things about it are cool, some things about it not so much. Overall opinion from me, not great. Especially for $60. Not super happy about that. Let me know what you think about it in the comments. That's all I got to say, and I'll talk to you again soon.